Holy shit! Holy shit! Okay, I need to talk about the episode because damn, this Super Nintendo World is really, very, very super extreme awesome, and damn, this episode. Holy shit! I did not see it coming. I need to talk about it. So sorry, this guy spoiled. And hey, I'm Ian. I'm Super Nintendo World episode 9. What is subject? By Super Nintendo World episode ever. And holy shit, episode. Damn, that massive bomb show that I did not see coming. I never suspected this was gonna happen, but always the thing. Kind of, sort of. So yeah, this should be fun. Okay, what do you mean when you're funny, you know? What's the big plot of Super Mario World Warrior 7 episode 9, I tell you? Lord's Christian Quad Team at the Pizza Guys and then a small with the Morgan Edge. Not big the partner, so. Alright, now going in the episode, look, as you want to know, I actually want to know, I love this show, that's awesome, especially my family, it's a great show, and a great accident to my series. Granted, they all changed around for the Tomorrow stuff with John, now I heard Power, but you know what, at this point, fuck it. At this point, I'll take what I can get. And, oh boy, this episode is a major bombshell that I need to talk about. So, spoiler, that's in the episode already, but I need to talk about this. So, okay. We probably figure out what more is planned. It's planned to use as Kryptonite than Power's humans, but we know it's probably. But here's the thing, though. That's a lot more sinister, more about the involvement in this plot, and it involves, after well, but is using after well, a subject actually from Smallville. Meaning, all the people who spoke about Kryptonite are all from Smallville. So the people who accept the Kryptonite were exposed to it a lot more than, well, Biddy, anyone else. So, anyone who's not from Smallville, they're not getting affected and not accept the hearse. But, yeah, there's a side effect, you know, they're freaking insane, crazy. Well, okay, they don't go crazy. They get really brainwashed into Kryptonians. And, yeah, that part might be, that's kind of confusing. But they read about it, and I have another development with John, well, Jordan Powers, he gets freeze breath. Yeah, I can be a man, but Jordan gets freeze breath at the end of the episode, and that's pretty interesting how to explain it. Thanks to very decent Ben Kryptonite, he has to affect him like Superman does. And Superman is with bullets, but, it's just, no bullets, he's fine, he just shoots them anyway, but that's not what we're talking about. That stuff is important, yes, but you have to be very interesting where that goes. And, yeah, though I didn't know my boy John had the power in the show, you know what? Fine, I'll accept at this point. I may not like it, but nothing we can do. So, I am showing me to you what's going on with Jordan Carter right now. Jordan Carter been injured so far. And, well, I never know if he's getting more development of powers because that's kind of what John Kent's pull up from the comics. At this point, I gotta accept what I got because, hey, different universe, different rules, and whatever. At this point, I'll tear my game. But, let's get the real bombshell on your title. Let's get to Morgan Edge. Okay, this part I not suspected to happen. I not see it coming, and I need to tell you. So, big spoiler, not seen the episode, I need to tell you. So, apparently, Morgan Edge is not from this world. No. But he's also a Kryptonian. Kind of. Sort of. I think he's too much brother. Okay, you're probably confused about that bit. But tell me, that makes no sense. Superman didn't have a boy in the comics, or at the end of the media. True! That part, I don't do it yet, but here's the thing though. I don't think, you know, this is actually, well, but his brother. No. That, the Superman that's actually Morgan Edge's body, I think that's the evil Superman from the other universe. Meaning, that the other Superman from the evil, well, the evil Superman from John Henry's Iron Nazi world, did have to get to this world. How is that possible? How did he actually get into Morgan Edge's body? My bet you're gonna get a crisis. Think about it. Crisis actually reset the multiverse, it destroyed all reality, and then the reality came back. So, anyway, this can explain how Morgan had powers. It's gonna explain how Morgan and General had to kind of against human brother. Because it's not very the real Morgan, it's actually the other human, the evil human who really got corrupted and went nuts. Yeah, that's what I'm going with, and that would make a ton of sense. Oh, by the way, also Wallowing's father also gets powers as well, but yeah, apparently he didn't know about the brainwashing stuff, so yeah, I think in general, now we know where he's going. He either got either sacrifice himself, or better get turned up, which he did, tried to attack Lois and John, which he did, and I think I know where that part went going now. I think he should probably sacrifice himself and probably die. Which makes sense, because he did fuck up, so, I get it, I really do. While that is the point inside, it does kind of make sense from that perspective. By the way, the whole Superman and Jordan stuff after the incident in 4, you go to 4 Solid, you get the Kryptonite album, and it's actually very painful and very actually sad and depressing. And very, not dark, obviously, not super, super dark, but it is very interesting how to get the Kryptonite out of Jordan. Granted, it's a thing I did not expect that to happen in regards to that comic, but yeah, like I said, I can't really compare it to coming to the shows, you know, like, I'll tell you when I get there, I have to be an engineer to do it. Also, the whole Lord talks about her body with Dr. Vader, and they sound depressing, but Dr. Vader is really great. As I said, the acting is so amazing, the story by the means of all, and I am very intrigued with the next episode, because the next episode, holy shit, we can't wear that Nazi coin, I am very intrigued. I can't see that beat. Oh boy, episode 10, I think it's been doing your hand in high gear, and I can hardly wait. This show might do everything I've won, I think it's super episode of all, and I cannot wait to see you next. But that way, we wish you. But, anywho, I talk. I think everyone can transport. I'll be waiting. Alright, what do I do? What do you guys? Superman Roy, episode 9, Royal Subjects. I get one of them, yay. Bye, perfection, A+. The best Superman Roy to me, watch the show. Best Superman family, watch the show. So, this was the best Superman show we had in a very, 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 very long time, and I can't really understand this, right, dude? See, they like, finally got a good show on it, because look at that. Flash had went downhill, Batwoman is bad. Red and Tomorrow, it's a comedy. That guy dropped that one in Tomorrow. Never getting bad, because they kind of lost all momentum in that show. Star Wars is good, but other than that, though, that's all we got. These are great shows of all, and I can't wait to see them next. Fine, so we got that break, it was the end. But anyway, what else? Oh, no. Don't worry about Superman Lord, episode 9, Royal Subject. Will be possible on please comment down below if you like it in the show. Do I get to be able to get to it on Twitter? Please subscribe my channel for picking the bell kind of episode. So, please, if you can, I'll talk one way. What would you be having with that episode? Because I think that episode will hit in the high gear, and I can hardly wait. That could be awesome. But until then, we'll see you. Don't worry about Superman Lord, episode 9, Royal Subject. Please comment below. Also, if you want to, please subscribe my channel. You can start to the bell, kind of, you can't. Well, okay, see you more. See ya. Bye, see you more. See ya. Bye.